I'm going to show you around some of those special places, the ones that haven't been discovered by the rest of the world.
This one's called Kelly Talton's, an undersea world you can dive right into without ever getting your feet wet. Of course, this isn't the only place that's full of water and teeming with fish, but come topside,
and I'll tell you more about the top end of New Zealand.
New Zealand, you say? Heard the name, but where exactly is it? Well, if someone will toss me a globe, I'll show you. Thanks. The Pacific Ocean, United States, Hawaii, and down here, New Zealand. And this yellow bit with Auckland at the bottom, that's where you and I are going to do some exploring.
Oh, and I've invited a friend of mine to join us. This is Julia.
Hello. Welcome aboard.
Yep. Boats and beaches, sparkling waters and beautiful islands. They're all here within a stone's throw of each other. Catch the up elevator and take a look for yourselves.
Perhaps you fancy a harbour cruise? Then look out for the blue and white sails and climb aboard the Pride of Auckland. She leaves from the foot of Queen Street, right in the heart of the downtown. And if we go up a bit higher and then turn towards the harbour entrance, we see some of the many small islands which dot this marine playground. But let's take a closer look at the city itself. So you see, it's not all water and boats.
Hey, they didn't sound bad, did they?
They're great.
I'll be back in a minute. I just want to try on this jacket I saw yesterday.
Right. Something a little different? Try Auckland.
The oldie-worldie feel of traditional arcades and department stores, or perhaps something rather more modern, fashioned in leather and wool. What about a silk suit with a tie to match? Or a power shell and silver necklace? A painting, perhaps, to hang on the wall? Or a piece of handcrafted pottery or glass? Souvenirs of a place that's just a little different. A place with sweet things to eat and old things to put them on. A place where charming colonial buildings provide a relaxed atmosphere to shop for that special something. No to silver? Then what about a homespun woolly sweater? Just the thing for those northern winters. And if you have a sudden craving for a pot of green-lipped mussels, some venison pate, or a slice of ripe brie, then you're in just the right place. Now, Julia has a particular craving for clothes. And not just any old clothes, but designer originals.
Do you like this one?
Really great. You look terrific. Hey, that one's sensational.
I think I'll wear it when you take me out to dinner this evening.
You're on. Though we haven't had lunch yet.
And when you want a break from the hectic rush, a bite to eat and a cool glass of wine, there's no shortage of places to go.
San Marino sounds Italian.
It might sound Italian, but it's made here in New Zealand, not 25 minutes from the centre of Auckland.
And if you're interested in wine, take a tour of the vineyards. 40 at the last count.
Yeah, try that.
Thanks. Your health.
Mmm, light fruity wine, just right before an afternoon on the town. Or is it the country?
What about a dollar each way on number 5?
Come on!
Well, maybe you'd prefer something that moves a little faster. An afternoon's bowling?
You'll be lucky to hit anything.
How's that?
Plenty to do. Just take your pick. Now for something rather more sedate. A chance to experience train travel the way it used to be, in those romantic days of steam. And of course, if you like fossicking through market stalls, then you've come to the right spot.
What a lovely silk shirt.
Yeah, just right for a day at the beach.
Beautiful, isn't it? And just under an hour from downtown Auckland. The West Coast. A place to get away from it all. A place where you don't have to worry too much about what you wear.
And speaking of clothes, it's time to go back to the hotel to change and freshen up. Then out into the evening to satisfy those healthy appetites all that sun and sea air have given us.
How does a long cool drink sound?
Sounds great. Give me 10 minutes for a shower.
10 minutes it is then.
Not a bad hotel, this, and they have terrific showers. Just give me a minute, and then join us for a cold Steinlager.
Cheers.
Cheers.
To a wonderful day.
And an exciting evening to come.
Coming towards senior restaurant.
The problem is choice. With enough restaurants to eat out every night of the year, how do you choose?
That was easy. It had to complement my dress.
Bon appetit.
What should we do after dinner?
Well, we could take in a show. Or dance the night away. An evening of harness racing. And a casual supper afterwards. Visit to the theatre. And later, a little late night relaxation.
Time to say goodbye. I'm off to LA in the morning, so maybe I'll see you there. If not, why don't you come on down here and visit?
But don't go away. Give me time for a quick nap, and then meet me by the pool for breakfast.
Lover, where can you be?
Nothing like a quick swim before breakfast by the pool. Unless, of course, it's lunch on the beach.
And to think we're only a couple of miles from the hustle and bustle of central Auckland.
Here's a friend of mine I'd like you to meet. This is Jackie.
Hi. Dave said he was taking you up north for a few days and asked if I'd like to join you. Well, what could I say?
Up here in the far north, they've got some of the biggest sand hills you've ever seen. They've also got these amazing machines for going over them on.
Thank you.
At the bottom of that great mountain of sand, the sea. Mile after mile of endlessly pounding surf and a broad ribbon of sand they call 90 Mile Beach. Smooth and flat as a race course. Just the place to take a turn on one of these beauties. Of course, there are other ways of travelling 90 Mile Beach. Just 15 minutes away is the quiet rural community of Kaitaia. There you can catch a comfortable coach to whisk you up the beach to Cape Reinga, meeting place of the Tasman Sea and the mighty Pacific Ocean. And those giant trees poking their heads through the forest canopy are kauri, once much sought after as masts for the tall ships which plied the seas between New Zealand and the Old World.
Those two are headed for the high country. I wonder if the trees are even bigger up there.
It could be, but there aren't many big kauris left. The early settlers used most of them for timber.
But how do they get them out of the bush? This one must weigh tons.
They used teams of bullocks to haul the logs through the bush to rivers where they were floated down to sawmills. While most pioneer buildings were of wood, the stone store at Kerikeri is still providing supplies to weary travellers. Travellers whose homes were once wooden cottages like this one. Although not lived in now, it's been completely restored, even down to the pots and pans on the stove.
The past is interesting, but I wouldn't want to bake bread this way too often.
But European history is not the only history in New Zealand. The Maori arrived many centuries before the European. They travelled from Polynesia in large ocean-going canoes, none of which survive today, although war canoes like this one have survived. Having no written language, they recorded their history in song, story, and visual decoration. Young Maori keeping alive the rites and rituals of the world their ancestors lived in.
Think what these trees have seen in their lifetimes.
Yeah, a lot can happen in 1,200 years. But enough of the past. There's plenty happening now.
Isn't it beautiful? Makes me want to jump straight in.
Go ahead. There's no nasty, creepy crawlies in there. In fact, the most you'd find in there would be a trout.
That reminds me, when are we going fishing?
Aha! There's some great game fishing around New Zealand. Markos, striped and blue marlin. They're all out there just waiting to be caught.
Right. Ah, go back!
Here we go! Right. How's that?
Come on, come on, come on, don't put it in harder.
down and I lost them.
Don't worry, you can have some of mine.
There are hotels if you want them, but we prefer a more relaxed atmosphere. We can even cook Jackie's fish here.
And after a hard day's fishing, what better than a relaxing soak in a naturally heated mineral pool and a glass of freshly squeezed keri-keri orange juice?
What do you mean, hard day? You let yours get away.
And now it's time to explore an idyllic marine paradise, the Bay of Islands, and at its heart, Russell, New Zealand's oldest European settlement and popular base camp for visiting the 140 islands of the bay.
You lot, we were supposed to pick up the yacht half an hour ago.
Wakey, wakey. You two are obviously too comfortable in there.
What time is it?
Time we were all down at the wharf.
If you're not there in half an hour, we'll go without you.
They're too late. They'll have to swim after us. Cast off, able seaman.
What's all this able seaman nonsense? I thought I got to be captain this time round.
And if you want to sail the Bay of Islands but haven't the time to charter a yacht, then climb aboard Tiger Lily and be taken for the cruise of your lives.
So you finally made it.
Well, we got the biggest taxi we could find. There you go.
Hi.
There's really good diving around New Zealand's coasts. It's not bad here in the bay, but the offshore islands are fantastic. Rather too far for us this time, though. And after exploring the fascinating realms of the deep, it's time to surface and discover a deserted sandy cove for a lie in the sun and something to eat.
It's been a great few days. I only wish it could go on longer. I hope you enjoyed yourselves and that one day you'll come and visit us in this very special corner of the world.